This video illustrates solutions to three types of percent problems. Then we develop a formula for solving percent problems by showing a connection to the solutions obtained from using hundredths squares. In solving percent problems, there are three important quantities. The whole, represented by a unit square, the percent, and the pat. In today's problem, we will be given the whole and the percent, and we will find the pat. The school year has 180 days, and if 35% of these days are left, how many days in the school year are left? The whole square represents 180 days, and we will shade 35 small squares to represent 35%. To find the value of one small square, we spread the 180 days out evenly over the 100 small squares by dividing. 180 divided by 100 equals 1.8 days per square. And we label one small square with 1.8 days. To find the value of the 35 small squares that represent the number of school days left, we multiply 35 times 1.8 equals 63 days left. And 35% of 180 equals 63 days left. The total number of days, 180, minus the 63 days left, 180 minus 63 equals 117 days that have been used. In the next problem, we will be given the whole and the pat, and we will find the percent. If 25 acres of land are given to a community, and the donor requires that 6 acres of this land will be developed as a playground, what percent of the land will be playground? We are given the whole, 25 acres, and we can find the value of each small square by computing 25 divided by 100 equals 25 hundredths of an acre. So we record this. We are also given that pat of the 25 acres, 6 acres, will be for a playground. So to determine how many 25 hundredths of an acre, small squares, are needed for 6 acres, we compute 6 divided by 25 hundredths equals 24. So 24 small squares or 24% of the land will be playground. And 24% of 25 acres equals 6 acres. In this example, we will give in the whole, 25 acres, and the pat, 6 acres, and we showed that 6 acres is 24% of the whole. In the next problem, we will use the percent in the pot to find the whole. The third type of percent problem involves discounts. If a sweater is on sale at a discount of 30% off and the discounted cost is $21.60, what is the original price of the sweater? The original cost of the sweater is represented by the whole square. And we shade this square for 30%. Since 30 small squares represent $21.60, we need to spread $21.60 evenly over the 30 small squares. We do this by dividing $21.60 divided by 30 equals 72 hundredths of a dollar. And we record this, 72 hundredths of a dollar, that one small square. The value of 100 small squares is 100 times 72 hundredths of a dollar. That's equal to $72. The original cost. So $72 is the value of the whole square. And 30% of $72 equals $21.60. The 70 unshaded squares is the discounted price the consumer pays, not counting taxes. And this is $72 minus $21.60 equals $50.40. The price the consumer pays. Let's look at a formula for solving percent problems. Please recall that in the first of the three problems we solved in this lesson, we found 35% of 180 school days by computing 35 times 180 divided by 100. In this quotient, is 180 days divided by 100 to obtain the value of one small square. And then we multiply by 35 for the 35 small squares. This product can be written as 35 divided by 100 times 180. And since 35 divided by 100 equals 35 hundredths, this product can be written as 35 hundredths times 180. This product, decimal times whole, is an example of the formula percent times whole equals pat. Given any two of the three numbers in this formula, we can find the third. Let's use this formula to check the results of the problem involving the discount cost of a sweater that we solved earlier in this lesson. The discount was 30%, which we write as 30 hundredths, times the whole, and this equals $21.60, the amount of the discount. So we are given two of the three numbers, and the whole is the missing number. The missing factor in a product can be found by dividing. For example, 6 times missing factor equals 24 is found by dividing the product by the other factor, which in this example is 6. And so we do the same thing to find the whole in this example. The whole equals $21.60 divided by 30 hundredths, and that equals $72. We'll use this formula in video 14 to solve problems where the percent is greater than 100%. You have seen illustrations using hundred squares that can help students understand and solve percent problems. Then we developed a formula based on the steps in these solutions.